না ওই টিচার বলে আসিস স্যার, আনমিউট আনমিউট স্যার, আসিস স্যার,
ইয়েস অডিবল।
ইট ইজ ক্লিয়ারলি অডিবল। হ্যাঁ আসিস স্যার, নাও ইট ইজ অডিবল
ইয়েস ইয়েস অডিবল।
ক্লিয়ার অর সাম নয়েজ ইজ কামিং, নাও
নো
ইট ইজ
নো,
অলমোস্ট ক্লিয়ার।
অলমোস্ট
ওকে
অলমোস্ট অলমোস্ট ক্লিয়ার।
ওকে ওকে।
হ্যাঁ স্যার, কি শোনা যাচ্ছে? হ্যালো,
হ্যাঁ ইয়েস অনির্বাণ,
ক্লিয়ার শোনা যাচ্ছে?
আসিস স্যার, আই সেন্ড ইউ দ্য ইউটিউব লিঙ্ক ইন ইউর মেল। আসিস স্যার, ইউ ক্যান চেক ইউর মেল।
ওকে, আই এম চেকিং।
অ্যান্ড ইট ইজ অলসো ওয়ার্কিং। ওকে, ইউ ক্যান চেক ইট।
ইয়েস ইয়েস, ইট ইজ রানিং।
ইট ইজ ওয়ার্ক। ওকে, ইউ ক্যান সেন্ড দ্য লিঙ্ক, নো প্রবলেম। শুরু।
শোনা যাচ্ছে?
হ্যাঁ অলক দা শোনা যাচ্ছে।
আচ্ছা
ক্লিয়ার। হ্যাঁ
স্যার শুনতে পাচ্ছেন? আশিস স্যার?
হ্যাঁ স্যার শুনতে পাচ্ছি।
আমার অডিও ঠিক আছে?
অডিও ঠিক আছে, তবে আপনার ওখানে স্যার কুয়াশা হয়েছে।
কুয়াশা হয়েছে আমি,
মানে
এটা ক্লিয়ার নয়?
না ক্লিয়ার নয়,
টপিকটা ক্লিয়ার নয়। দাঁড়ান, দেখি কুয়াশা থেকে কি করে মুক্তি পাওয়া যেতে পারে।
গুড আফটারনুন স্যার, গুড আফটারনুন আশিস, গুড আফটারনুন দিলীপ
ম্যাডাম, গুড আফটারনুন।
অনির্বাণ অলসো, আচ্ছা গুড আফটারনুন।
না না, গুড আফটারনুন ম্যাডাম,
গুড আফটারনুন, বেস্ট অফ লাক।
থ্যাংক ইউ ম্যাডাম।
না স্যার এখনো হয়নি স্যার, আমার ক্যামেরাটাই প্রবলেম আছে।
আমরা ক্যামেরা প্রবলেম, ঠিক আছে আমরা ক্যামেরা প্রবলেম। লাইট তো বাড়িয়েছি। আচ্ছা মডারেটর কে আছে? অনির্বাণ
লাইট আসছে বোধ হয় একটু পেছনে।
অনির্বাণ তুমি একটু দূরে রয়ে গেছো মনে হচ্ছে।
অনির্বাণ আপনি একটু কাছে আসুন, অনেক দূরে আছেন। আশিস স্যার কুয়াশা সরেছে একটু? ধরেনি
আপনার মনে হয় সামনের দিক থেকে কোনো আলো আছে?
না সামনে কিছু আলো নেই, আমার ক্যামেরার সমস্যা আছে এটা। ক্যামেরা সমস্যা। ডিজি স্যার কতজন জয়েন করেছে?
23।
আচ্ছা, আর এই রেজিস্ট্রেশন কতজন?
60। আশিস স্যার, স্যার অলরেডি জয়েন অর নট? আশিস স্যার,
স্যার উইল বি জয়নিং সুন, আই হ্যাভ জাস্ট টক টু হিম।
ওকে,
গুড মর্নিং, গুড আফটারনুন স্যার। Good afternoon to all of you.
Okay, sir. Sir will be joining soon. I have just talked to him.
Good afternoon to all of you.
Those are outside campus. We will not talk to them.
মোবাইল থেকে ঢুকতে পারছিলাম না, অ্যাপটা ডাউনলোড করলে। আশিস দা মেনশন করে দিতে পারতেন যে মোবাইল থেকে জয়েন করা যাবে না বা অ্যাপটা ডাউনলোড করতে হবে। মোবাইল থেকে জয়েন করা যাচ্ছে না, আর একটু মেনশন করে দিন মেলে।
ডিজি স্যার,
না মোবাইল থেকে করা যাচ্ছে কিন্তু সামওয়্যারটা ডাউনলোড করতে হয়, ওই অ্যাপটা ডাউনলোড করতে
হয়। হ্যাঁ, ইউ হ্যাভ টু ডাউনলোড, আদারওয়াইজ হাউ ইট ইজ পসিবল ফর মোবাইল, এভরি অ্যাপ্লিকেশন ইউ হ্যাভ টু ডাউনলোড।
ডিজি স্যার, এই অরুণাবু কি বলছে, কি সমস্যা?
আরে ইউ হ্যাভ টু, হ্যাঁ আমি ওকে কথা বলেছি, আদারওয়াইজ ইট উইল না ফর, আরে ফর এনি প্ল্যাটফর্ম, ফ্রম গুগল ক্লাসরুম অর গুগল অ্যাকচুয়ালি ক্লাস।
It is same for Zoom also.
হ্যাঁ জুম এনি ফর অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইন ল্যাপটপ ইউ ক্যান ওপেন ইন ব্রাউজার বাট ইন মোবাইল ফোন ইট ইজ নট পসিবল ফর এভরি কেসেস গুগল মিট হোয়েদার ইউ ইউজ গুগল মিট জুম অর এনিথিং
অনির্বাণ শুরু করে দাও নাকি দিলীপ?
হ্যাঁ স্যার স্যার অ্যাকচুয়ালি স্টিল স্যার
স্যার কি জয়েন করেছেন?
না উনি জয়েন করছেন বললেন, তা একটু সময় লাগবে,
করলে শুরু করে দেবো।
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে।
হ্যাঁ
ডিজি স্যার, স্যার জয়েন করেছেন?
ওকে ওকে ওকে
শুরু শুরু গুড আফটারনুন স্যার।
গুড আফটারনুন এভরিবডি, উই অল আর ওয়েলকাম ইন দিস ওয়েবিনার অন ইম্প্রুভমেন্ট অফ টিচিং অ্যান্ড লার্নিং প্রসেস। সো টু স্টার্ট দিস ওয়ান, সো আই welcome Dr. Dilip Kumar Gayan for his welcome address. Professor Gayan, please.
Okay, very good afternoon. Respected Professor Rabindranath Mukherjee, Professor Department of Chemistry, Indian Institute of Technology, Kanpur. Professor Colonel Prabhas Bose, Director of our College. Professor Ashish Mitra, Professor Anirban Das, Mr. Alok Maiti, and my dear colleagues. It's my immense pleasure to welcome you for this webinar on improvement of teaching and learning process. Teaching is more important, sorry, learning is more important than teaching. Just wait. Now I start the recording. Learning is most important than teaching. Teaching has no value if it does not result in learning on the part of the students. With the advancements of technology, method of teaching and learning has been changed in the current scenario. Teaching is the key component in education planning, which is one of the most important factor in steering education plan. Teaching means act, practice, or professions of a teacher. It is the process of giving shape one thought and action through education, instruction, and performing practices that lead to a new behavior and capacity in the students. Teaching can be conducted using several methods based on the nature of the subject and customized according to the students. Teaching is a complex, complicated activity which often requires flexible juggling with number of tasks and goals simultaneously. A variety of students' characteristics affect learning. Prior subject knowledge determines the absorption of new learning. Teaching methodology involves acquiring relevant knowledge about students and use it to upgrade course design and classroom teaching. Learning is the process of acquiring new or modifying existing knowledge, behavior, skill, values, and preferences. As teaching and learning is an integral process, good teaching method and techniques will help students to learn, think better, It will provide guidance and help in enhancing skills which are connected with future in order to successful and a good contributor to the society. Hence, the art of teaching need to be improved continuously in order to improve the quality of the life and further development. Not only teachings and learning, but also evaluations method plays an important role. Continuous changes and modifications as per requirement enhance the education systems. The systematic approach towards planning and execution of educational program is essential for overall development and growth of the student, teachers, as well as educational program. In the present pandemic situation, the teaching is done through online and hybrid mode, which is the upgraded versions of the basic classroom teaching using technology. The webinar will highlight all the aspects of good teaching method and technique for better understanding of our students. Looking forward to your cooperation and support for this grand success. With this note, I conclude here. Thank you. Thank you all. Now I request Anirban sir to continue the session. Anirban sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Gandhi. Now I am inviting Professor Dr. Cornel Provas Bose, Director of our Institute, CEMK, for his keynote address. Professor Bose, please. So please unmute your mic. Sorry to say, pardon, sir.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Respected Professor Rabindranath Mukherjee, sir, the teaching fraternity of the College of Engineering Management, Kolaghat, I welcome all of you in this webinar, which is applicable to all of us and aptly titled Improvement of Teaching and Learning Process. Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, who was the first Vice President and second President of India, he was a great scholar, academician, philosopher, and a great teacher. He once said, and I quote, "A teacher is the best minds in the country," I unquote. Technical teachers associated with education contribute a major share to overall education system and plays a vital role in the social and economical development of the society. It is to be noted that the 21st century presents a radically different economy and society that demands realignment of the knowledge dissemination by the teachers. In this regard, the key features like globalization and sustainability, information and communication technology revolution, emergence of knowledge society, and rapid knowledge obsolescence are some of the factors to be taken into account by the teachers teaching the students. There's no doubt that the technical teachers are proficient in their subject domain and its application. But where it matters is that they should have the requisite delivery skill to communicate their knowledge and skill to the students in an effective, attractive, and interesting manner. In this regard, National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research, in collaboration with AICTE, they're playing an important role and have developed pedagogy module as MOOCs courses on Swayam platform. Presently, these modules are structured for technical teachers of the level of assistant professor with less than 5 years of service in AICTE approved colleges. In the near future, they're also planning similar pedagogy for associate professors and the professors. Each module is equivalent to 1 week of faculty development program, and on successful completion of all the modules and project work, the teachers will get a certificate from NITTT, which would help them in their career progression also. In the present era of smartphone, a teacher faces a new challenge to deal with the students who are tech savvy and have the feeling that he or she knows everything because of Googleism. In addition to the updated content, a teacher needs to concentrate in communication skill and modes of knowledge dissemination. In this regard, stress on technology-enabled learning, lifelong self-learning, creative problem-solving, innovation, and R&D, etc., are required to be inculcated to the students from the very beginning. The teachers are expected to be the role model of professional values, ethics, ecology, sustainable development, etc., so that the same can be emulated by their students when they become the professionals. I remember in his valedictory address in the webinar NAP 2020, which was organized in 12th May this year, Professor R.N. Mukherjee sir, who is the plenary speaker today, shared his recipe to become a better teacher based on his experience as teacher of about 4 decades. He also shared his thought on the choice of research topic and touched upon on the issues of scientific temper. Today, we are eager to hear from you, sir, and learn the finer points on improvement on teaching and learning process. With this, I hand over the session to our moderator, Dr. Anirban Das, and we are eagerly waiting for you, sir. Jai Hind, we are waiting for the webinar to start. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Director, sir. So now I am inviting Professor Rabindranath Mukherjee for his plenary talk. Professor Mukherjee is a professor in the Department of Chemistry, Emeritus Fellow of IIT Kanpur. Professor Mukherjee, please.
So good afternoon, everyone. So I first of all, I would like to thank Dr. Ashish Mitra, Dr. Dilip Gayan, and the director of the institute, Professor Dr. Prabhas Bose, and moderator, Dr. Anirban Das. When I was contacted to say something on this issue, being a Bengali person and living in IIT Kanpur for the last more than 34 years, so it has been a pleasure to share some of my thoughts and views in teaching and also in the research. Now, one thing you have to help me, how do I share the screen? How do I share the screen? Can you tell me?
Sir, you can see a white circular thing. There will be arrow direction left side.
No,
right corner, sir.
Down.
Yeah.
The plus sign is there.
Oh, plus sign. Yeah, there will be plus.
So there is a plus sign this side.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Okay. And then upload a presentation.
Yeah.
I think that is the one.
That's.
No.
Then you confirm it, share the respective files or folders. Select your files, then you confirm.
Okay. This is the file I have, and I have to just 1 minute. Just a minute. I'll manage. See, upload present a presentation, share an external video. I think upload a presentation. So presentation upload. How do I do?
For the browse, there is your browse button is there. Just you browse.
Okay. So from there, from browse button, I should go to the file.
File, yes.
Right. Yeah, I am now getting. Okay. And this is my academic. And then academic priority, this one. And then lectures.
Mm. Now
I think you can, yes.
It is visible to us.
Okay. Yes. So now what I do, it is better for me to make it bigger. Zoom in. Anyway, you can see. The title of my talk, what I have decided, the philosophy of teaching, and you see with the different colors I have put and the research. Say, and the research I have said because teaching without the research will have some problem. I will come to that point very soon. Now, the thing is, the next slide, how can I make it a full screen? Full screen. Can you see now?
Yes, it is clear.
Yes. So I said the following first one. So now it is a full screen. So I have already said that the title of my talk. So let us start with the knowledge. All of us will know, but the way I look at things, I have kept it that way. Knowledge is what? It's a familiarity with someone or something. It's not only education, which can include facts, information, descriptions, or skills acquired through experience or education. So knowledge does not mean that I have to go to college and university or a PhD to be knowledgeable. Dr. Rabindranath Tagore, the Nobel laureate, he didn't do that, but still he had reached such a level that earned his Nobel Prize. Now the point which always comes to our mind, what are the key? How do we become a successful person? And what should be the recipe for a successful future? So in order to cope with the rapidity with which knowledge itself will change, whatever knowledge some 100 years back, today things have changed and tomorrow it will again change. So we must seek to achieve academic excellence. So the point is, these are buzzwords, academic excellence. So what does it mean? It means the following. Academic excellence, in our mind, is what? You get good marks, good grades, you are a great person. So I have written like this. Academic excellence is the demonstrated ability to perform, achieve, and or excel in scholastic activity. Traditionally, academic excellence has been identified with achieving high
Can't hear.
Sir, may be facing some internet connectivity problems. Please wait.
From sir side, after connectivity is gone. Sir has just disconnected. So please be patient.
Yeah, not at all audible.
Sir has disconnected.
Okay.
দিলীপ আমি স্যারকে বলেছি। অলক বাবু, অলক বাবু,
হ্যাঁ বলুন
স্যার, কানেকশন করতে পারছেন না স্যার, ওখানে আবার ক্লিক করে কানেকশন করতে পারছেন না। আমি স্যারের নাম্বারটা দেব,
আমি এখান থেকে কিভাবে
স্যারের নাম্বারটা তবু কথা বলবেন।
স্যার তো নেটওয়ার্ক, স্যার তো জয়েনই হতে পারছে না।
হ্যাঁ উনি ফোন করেছিলেন, বলছেন আমি কি নতুন করে কানেকশন করছি, কানেকশন ঢুকতে পারছি না। তুমি স্যারের নাম্বার জানো?
না না,
কথা বলো না, আমি চ্যাট বক্সে লিখে দিচ্ছি।
ঠিক আছে,
পেয়েছো দিলীপ? কথা বলো একটু স্যারের সাথে।
ঠিক আছে আমি কথা বলছি।
হ্যাঁ কথা বল।
order, but due to the current pandemic situation.
এবার দেখা যাচ্ছে?
হ্যাঁ স্যার দেখা যাচ্ছে।
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, লেট মি সি নাও। এখানে আই ওয়ান্ট টু চেঞ্জ দ্য স্লাইড নাও। ওহ No. Okay, this is what I was saying, academic excellence. And then, so basically, academic excellence does not mean that they just we see the full screen. That would have been fantastic. Okay. Can you see now full screen? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm so sorry. It is not my problem, but it is happening like this. So academic excellence is the demonstrated ability what to perform, to achieve and or excel in scholastic activity. Traditionally, whatever we feel that, it is basically identified with achieving high grades and superior performance. But it is not that. It is more than just getting good grades. It is the maximum development of our intellectual capabilities, potential and skills in service to humanity. That is basically the meaning of this thing. Now let us decide culture of excellence. This is a very, very important thing. Try to understand. Each one of us, we set a standard. And in our life, what do? We would like to achieve there. And when we are close to that achieving level, we should increase our expectation level. Then again, we work hard to get there. But then our expectation level should be even higher. And this is a never-ending process. Then only a human being will remain a creative person. So we, the members of the academic community, belong to an organization which stands for a culture of excellence. And excellence is not by accident. It is a process. How? Where an individual or an organization or a nation continuously strives to better oneself. I am doing, your institute is doing that way. The performance standards are set by individuals. They work on their dreams with focus and are prepared to take calculated risks. We have to take risks in life, otherwise you cannot achieve whatever you wanted to do. And do not get perturbed by, deterred by failures as they move towards their dreams. Then they step up their aspirations, increase the level as they tend to reach the original target. They strive to work to their potential. In the process, they increase their performance, thereby multiplying further their potential. And this is an unending life cycle phenomenon. It continues. So today, what I am today, I want to do even better tomorrow. And when I go to the tomorrow, my plan will be how do I do better than day after tomorrow. That should be. It is not that I am a happy man. We get some money, something, then nothing will happen. So academic excellence is set by no one else. So the person who is involved, they are not in competition with anyone else but themselves. I should decide myself. I should judge myself whether I am doing a good job or not. And if I am doing, how do I do even better? Not to see someone who is criticizing me or saying good to please me. Not like that. That's what I meant. Now, the point is, in the early days, knowledge was like that. See, you know, the Bhaskara and all those 500, 600, 1000 years back. But then the modern generation, a resurgence of the old spirit of scientific inquiry, I'm paying attention to science, took place in the beginning of the 20th century, when even under the colonial rule, Indians began to assert their intellectual potential in science. Even though we were not free, but the Indians started thinking on their own to make a big thing. Names like Ramanujan, the great mathematician, Jagadish Chandra Bose, the great physicist, Meghnath Saha, again physicist, Satyendranath Bose, again physicist, C.V. Raman, you know, Raman spectroscopy, Acharya Prakurchandra Ray are examples of these new researchers. They kept on coming and inspiring the whole nation, all over the world with their work. Take an example of the chemist, Acharya Prakurchandra Ray. He lived during 1861 to 1944. He was famous for preparation of mercurous nitrite. You will find it's not a very big thing. Big thing today, you can prepare. But the point is, it was a very big thing in those days. Why he is so famous? He was the founder of the Indian School of Modern Chemistry. So the modern chemistry, what we do today, it was nurtured and initiated by none other than Acharya Sarvachandra. And thus, in true sense, he was a pioneer of chemical industries in India. That means he was an academician to begin with, a chemist specifically, and then entrepreneur. So he was involved in all three. And this dress, can you make it? This man did his PhD at the University of Edinburgh in Scotland. So he had gone there, got educated, came back, Presidency College, and started giving something to the country. Whatever he earned, most of his money, he distributed, he donated for the betterment of human beings. Such a great personality. Now let us start with academic activity, teaching and research. I cannot say pay attention to teaching without the component of research. What do you mean? We, the teachers, should always remember that our primary academic activity is teaching. If we don't do a good teaching, then something we are cheating the system. And we blame the students are not very good. This is not true. Maybe we are not doing a great job. To do good teaching, one is supposed to read a lot. The books, what kind of books? Textbooks, reference books, and the relevant literature. And then make plans how to deliver in the classroom. Not just taking a book, some passage, some 5-6 pages, and manage a class. Not like that. Make plans how to deliver in the classroom. This allows the teacher to enhance his or her knowledge base. If I am not educated, what I will be teaching you? The main thing is I have to educate myself first to reach to your level and to give you more. Nobody can teach other person how to do good teaching. It is inherent. Books give a direction how to approach a particular topic, but it is the teacher who decides how to go about it. Books are there. You read a book, but you will find from teacher to teacher, it varies how to do it. So it varies how to present. So that variation is done by an individual. One should evolve own teaching methodology to start a new topic in the classroom. How do I start? The job is not only to teach, explaining the concepts and clearing the doubts, but to develop own style of delivering lectures. Getting involved in teaching and then to inspire the young minds. A good teacher not only teaches, but also performs. I'll just add one or two sentences. When I was a student in the University of Burdwan during 74-76, we had three fantastic teachers. One was Professor Sushil Siddhanta, he is no more. He had come to the class to teach luminescence, you know, solid state physics. But before he started teaching solid state physics, he started talking about light. And then he says, where from you can get light? If you, you know, rub two stones, there will be light. You have vegetable oil, mineral oil. Then why do you change efficiency? How to get a better light and which our eyes will be happy to accept? And then he started saying the old bulb came and then the tube light. And now you know a lot of the different designs of luminescent tubes and bulbs are now available. So he took a whole class, the entire class for 45 to 50 minutes just to give the background. And we were actually glued to the, you know, the sitting chair to listen to what this old man was saying. Such a fantastic teacher I have never seen in my life. But I will tell you, then I said a good teacher not only teaches but also performs, because the way he spoke, the way he inspired us, it has remained in my life. I have retired from IIT Kanpur in 2018. Then I have been today, this 30th June, I will be leaving IIT Kanpur, going to IIT ISM Dhanbad. But my 34-year stay at IIT Kanpur, in between 5 years at ISER Kolkata as a director, I have enjoyed teaching all the time. When I was a director, every year I have taught the first year students. I love teaching. And my teaching, the potential was ignited or initiated or encouraged by a person named Professor Sushil Siddhanta. He was our head of the department. The ingredients of good teaching are a distinct voice, articulative skill, board work, not only computer and all these, your, you know, PowerPoint presentation, board work, how do you write, how do you draw, and the personality in keeping the students in a happy and an interactive mood. If the students are there, bunk the class, no point in attending, something must be wrong with us, and we have to look for how to change ourselves. I have learned one lesson in my journey to teaching, looking for topics which other colleagues do not feel comfortable with to teach. There are many topics you will find, oh, it is too tough, or I don't enjoy, and you have to look for the domain which will be your area of teaching, your topics which other colleagues do not feel comfortable to teach. Following this, you create your own teaching domain. Always try to teach core courses to inspire young minds. It is very easy to teach elective courses, specialized courses, as you have some exposure during your PhD or postdoc. But when you teach the core courses, the young minds qualify, they have qualified their class two. And after class two, they are coming to, they would like to go to the higher, you know, higher education. And if your job is to get him motivated, and he will never forget. So I always get satisfaction when I teach first year BTech, inorganic portion of general chemistry course. First year MSc, the topics would mean my expertise, broad-based inorganic chemistry. Second year MSc, the topics of my interest, bio inorganic chemistry. And first semester PhD students, principles of a subject, and my subject is inorganic chemistry. So various subjects I have taught, and each and every subject I face the student with a different approach. The target must be to evolve own style of teaching, distinctly different from other colleagues. It is a hard job, but believe me, it is doable. Then, the point is, whatever I have said so far is based on my own experience at IIT Kanpur during these years. And there is a gap, that time I was at Isaac Kolkata, by teaching many core courses and elective courses. And then I have been recognized by students through students' feedback, that is in IIT Kanpur, and students' reaction survey is in Isaac Kolkata. And I suggest you, as you are interested to do improvement of teaching and learning process, you introduce the concept of students' feedback. We might say we are doing a great teaching. Let the students decide whether we are doing a great job or not. So I would urge the Vice Chancellor and the people who are attending my lectures, keep that in mind, take input from the students, and then the teachers will be realizing they are, you know, where they are lacking certain things. So the students will be happy to get that kind of teachers who motivates them maximum. How do you, the methods? It is not possible to give a recipe just like that. But from my own experience, I have jotted down certain things. In the first class, when I go, I mention the topics to be covered in the whole semester. I never keep on teaching. The first class, I mention the topics which I will be teaching in that course. And I always give the list of text and reference books so that the students don't have to run around, and which I plan to follow. Always make a very impressive introductory lecture. The first lecture, love at first sight kind of, the first introductory lecture is the most important of any topic. This helps the students to get connected with you and the topic. As I mentioned just now, for the Sushil Siddhanta luminescence, I will never forget in my whole life, and that is very important. It is a good idea to provide lecture notes, which I always do. Whatever I teach, I give them notes. At IITK, I always follow it. After 3-4 lectures, you should know whether my teaching is going on the right direction, or I am teaching but the students are not enjoying. Then teaching has no meaning. After every 3-4 lectures, take a stock to make sure that majority of students are in tune with you. If not, repeat the topics and get them connected. Just coming and finishing the syllabus has no meaning. The students will never enjoy. In my opinion, it is not a teaching if we teach but the students do not follow or enjoy. It is our job to make them enjoy our lecture. So you prepare the lecture in such a way, you practice your lecture, you deliver in such a way, the students got to get impressed by you and they will love the subject. Let us give home assignments. Now in a class, what do we think? Oh, if we give home assignment, again we have to correct it. You don't correct. Give home assignment after teaching 2-3 topics. If it is difficult to evaluate their performance, so don't worry. After a few days, provide model answer. Each and every question, write the answer. What you think best and to the point and crispy answer, not a history. Crispy answer, a few lines, so that it is completely based on concepts. And let them check on their own. This helps the students to get an idea about the nature of questions may be asked in the exam and to learn how to write point-wise answers. Not just writing history, but to the point how to answer. In the examination, I prefer setting questions well distributed with difficulty level. A few questions easy so that everyone will be able to attempt. And not so difficult, moderate, and few quite involved. Then what happens? To the entire class, you have given a package. The students who are not that great, they will be able to answer the easy questions and moderate ones. So getting reasonable good grade is not a problem. But for the best students, they will finish this and they will go to this quite involved one. And these kind of questions are difficult. Don't try to give questions from the textbook. Develop your own question style. Own style of question, which the students won't get in the textbook. You have to think over it, how to do it. And it is possible. I always provide model answer just after the examination. It is easy for the students to judge their own performance before they approach you for rechecking. In IIT, they say, sir, I have gotten poor marks, you have not given. I said, no, I am not your enemy. This is the question and that is the answer. Check whether you have written like that. Sir, somehow I did not write. And then what do? That is the answer. I have given you enough questions, home assignments. I provided you enough model answers, then I have set the question and various kinds of questions, easy, moderate and involved, and still if you have not learned how to answer, that is not my fault, that is your fault. You have to change your habits and be more and more involved in your education. Now the thing is, if it is internal grading, that's what happens in IIT, then be generous to assign good grades. No point in penalizing students. Never do that. Try to help the student. Borderline students, I always believe in, if a student gets a second class, that means his life is gone. Why the hell I do that if he is reasonably okay? If he has gotten around 50, some whatever, in IIT, percentage is not important because we give letter grades. So if I find that he is slightly down compared to others, I always try to push them. So a C student will get B and B student will get A. So that means they are not in fear. They don't try to avoid you. They would like to come to you for betterment of their knowledge. So borderline students will be pushed to the higher grades. At IIT Kanpur, we give letter grades. A, 4, best performance. B, 3, then after that. 2, D, 4, poor performance, but merely getting promoted. And F, fail. It has nothing to do with percentage. A best performance student might have gotten only 60%. No problem. Because the whole class, nobody could get more than 62. So 62% is the best student. And if the other students are getting 48 or 49, they are not too bad because they must belong to the B or C grade. They're not failing. It is a relative grading because I am teaching, I am setting the question paper, I am grading, so I know exactly who is what. We should be committed to enhancing the standing of the academic institutions we are part of. The teaching plays a pivotal role in monitoring today's students so that they become engaged citizens and tomorrow's leaders in all walks of life. If we put them in trouble, their career is gone. It is better to help them out, not to put them in trouble. This is a challenging job, and this should be our mission, to help the student so that tomorrow they become the leaders. Each one of us should set a standard of our own to become a good teacher. It is easy to say, but difficult to become. Just reading one or two books, making notes, and teaching in a classroom is quite routine, not at all difficult. You never become a good teacher. You become a just average teacher. A good teacher means the students will read 20 books, 30 books, till they will not find what you have said, the way you have explained, and that is not written in any book. Because you have achieved that, you have thought about it, and with your thinking process, you have presented with appropriate language, and your gesture and your board work or PowerPoint, the students will follow. Then come, let us ask ourselves, how many good teachers we have come across in our academic journey? The answer which comes to our mind is a very small number. Many teachers, but not great teachers. To my mind, a good teacher is the one who creates a permanent place in our mind. Whenever we think of teaching, according to me, an inspiring teacher is a philosopher who makes a lifelong impact in our mind through the topics he or she discussed in the classroom. Such teachers become our role model. Try to become a role model. Your wife, your director has said, that is very, very important. You go, you teach, no matter syllabus, you follow the syllabus, you can change always here and there. Nobody is going to come and check whether a particular small topic you have taught or not. Even students will say, sir, forget about that topic, we don't care. But you teach these things which are most important. Pay attention to that. Now you see, state-of-the-art higher education curricula must have a component of research. I have already said, and I will urge your director and the dean and the higher authority to bring the culture of research in teaching. I will touch upon some points. In my opinion, education or teaching is incomplete without research. Not very high funded research, even the college level research can be done. There are journals to publish. A young student, they will get charged to publish a few papers during their student days. And this is what happens in IITs and IISERs. IISERs and IIT, the students, when they have not passed MSc, still they have one or two papers. That is the way they get motivated. Now, what is research? It is actually, you know, it is a process of systematic inquiry, thinking, that entails collection of data, documentation of critical information, and analysis and interpretation of that data or information. In accordance with, how do I do it? Suitable methodologies. Who sets that? Set by specific professional fields. So every chemistry profession has certain methodologies. Physics has certain methodologies. Engineering has its own methodology. Engineering is a derived science. It comes from physics, chemistry, math, biology, and then you go to engineering. You cannot do engineering bypassing physics, chemistry, math. No. So it is step by step. And suitable methodologies are available is the basic backbone of any subject in the professional fields and academic disciplines. Now the question is, scientific methodology and ethics in university education. Ethics plays a major role. You might think that how, during the last 7 centuries, you take it, universities have played a crucial role in the development of science education. Currently, changes are occurring in the social and institutional structure of science. Because you will find Kolaghat is a place, there may be 100 Kolaghats in the country, maybe 1000 Kolaghats. But your Kolaghat should be much better and unique in the sense, can compete with other so-called Kolaghats, that's what I have said. So compared to other institutes, you should have some unique features. Because of that, the unique teachers, because of that, the students will get attracted, and the kind of education they will get, they will tell others, put your kids there, that's a good school. And that is very important. Because the activities of different research institutes provide considerable contributions to many fields of science in many countries. Now the point is, only teaching is one place. In IITs, in ISERs, teaching and research both. Now the students will be happy to come to IITs. Why? Young mind, if they get selected, then attend lectures. And in the early age, when you are only how much, some 18, 19, 20, you start doing some research of a, I mean, you know, humble level, not very high funda. And then you learn the process of research. What is so great about research? Why people are interested in doing research? That thing is important. So there are research institutions, there are IITs, NITs, ISERs, and there are universities, and there are institutes like your at Kolhapur. The universities have remained and will remain the major, if not the only, place where a novice, a young mind, acquires the necessary knowledge to be able to make original contributions to science education. So that means universities or your institute, if you continuously only teach, and component of research in the form of teaching, you have to bring it. I'm just saying inorganic chemistry is my field. If I say some metal ion, some ligand, there's a field created, which is taught in as crystal field theory. And there is certain phenomena by which today we have the material science or the smart molecules. So what is smart molecule? During your teaching in the classroom, if you tell them, and they will get attracted to prepare to synthesize those smart molecules which are used in, say, mobile phones or fantastic all electronic gadgets. So that is very important. Now the point is, the universities have remained and will remain the major knowledge base. It is obvious to anyone following the course of university education during the last 3-4 decades that some fundamental changes have occurred. What is that? Too many students. Because of the enormous increase in the number of students, what has happened? The interaction of the students with the teachers have gone down. If the number of students were less, the teacher knows the names of every individual, and the students used to feel comfortable with interacting with the teachers. But if there are too many, in IIT, IIT Kanpur, I have taught a course, I had a class, in that class, I had 470 students. A huge auditorium. So 470 means I am teaching using a microphone and all kinds of things. But you know that one-to-one touch which I used to have when I was a student, that is missing because of, you know, tremendous growth in the number of students, and we need more and more institutes, we need more and more teachers, and more number of students will get appropriate education. Now the universities have become a part of the modern research industry. Why industry word? Mass production of research. In the university system, they are doing research. Now, if you have to compete with IITs, IISERs, NITs, universities, better you introduce the concept of research in all your discipline at a moderate level, whose competitive spirit has influenced both enhancing and diminishing the activities of the traditional university. Enhancing means increase some more and more research, and some topics which are may not be that important, don't teach them, diminish them. So that way you make the course structure more vibrant or lovable to the student community, because they know if I attend this, if I learn this, for me doing research will be important, or I might get a good job and I will be able to earn more money. So education could we have all the components so that the students feel comfortable with it. Let us take the design, the domain, the arts, humanities, social sciences, science, ethics of science, and philosophy and religion. And you see, the circles are drawn in such a way. The science and arts, if you do good science, you have to learn how to speak well. You have to do good science, you have to know the ethics of science. You should be a philosopher to do good science, but religion is very different. So do not bring religion in the scientific education, it will never work. So things are, I'm not a political person, a political person, but I am saying you, religion and science belong to different, not overlapping sets. This I took it from an American journal because this is very important. Religion is religion. It is the human being's feeling, but science is documented. You can prove it. So there is, and this thing, two things never come together, but these three will come together. So remember the your subject domain, a humanity subject domain, ethics and philosophy subject domain, and the religion domain. Now the thing is, let us see, teaching the scientific approach. How do you teach? You say, I prepare, I teach. It is a difficult indeed. It is probably impossible to be able to make scientific discoveries by only reading about science and science. It don't work. So you have to bring the concept of research. If you just teach, students are coming, you are giving lectures, they are taking some notes, getting good marks, and that is not very scientific. Scientific, if you are teaching science, you must have the component of researching. What to teach? Factual knowledge or way of thinking? I would prefer way of thinking. No point in factual knowledge. You will be surprised. The great person Albert Einstein, he said, a lot of things I don't remember, but what I have forgotten, I can go and consult a textbook and I say, oh yeah, yeah, I forgot. But I can think on my own. So this is very, very important. You should have a brain independent of your, I mean, it is your brain to think on your own and it is not borrowed. So what to teach? Factual knowledge. This is very easy to teach. This guy said, this guy, that guy said, but way of thinking is more important. A popular dictum saying is that schools should not teach factual knowledge, but only effective ways of thinking. How to make correlations between the two parameters and meaningful conclusions. According to this view, it is superficial, very, you know, not very deep into it. To learn facts because it is easy to find them in books. So superfluous activity just to facts. Yeh karta hai and that does this. This dissolves in hydrochloric acid, that does not dissolve. And it is very easy. You can learn by heart. For that you don't have to come to a college or an university. You have the textbooks, you read it. But thinking should be inculcated in the minds of the student through your teaching. Some pitfalls of scientific research. What is that? The more fundamental a discovery, the greater the necessity for changing the formerly accepted view. Because a new discovery will replace the old one. However, it is equally obvious that greater discoveries require more thorough and more substantial proof than minor ones. So in a small place, if your facilities are bare minimum, you do research, not a very high level, high dimension, but at some moderate dimension, you bring it in your curricula, then the faculty members will get involved, they will keep themselves engaged, and they, in the process, they will invite students. I will show you some recipe which the Americans follow. And then, let us see, ethical problems. Ethics, you know, don't cheat. You say something, and by manipulation, it is unethical. So ethical problems of scientific research and publication. Because research publication means, I publish a paper, anyone in the whole world will be able to reproduce that. And whatever I have written, I am confident it is right. It should not be some managing kind of. The conduct of scientific research poses a great number of ethical problems. From the selection of the subject of scientific investigation to the publication of the results, which is finally we publish. A suggestion for university education, what to do? Although it would not solve the problem if courses on the methodological and ethical problems of scientific research were instituted at university. There should be a course. And now that kind of course are being taught in IITs and ISERs, at least at those with PhD programs. Because lower students forget it, but when they are doing research, then you do this. The present situation could be improved significantly. That what is ethics, what is so important of ethical standards will come to your mind once you have a course appropriately designed when you have a PhD program may not be applicable for your institute if you don't do that. The education of students is the major task, that is our primary job of most universities, and the value of that knowledge is exploited during employment. If a student is well qualified and understood the things appropriately, then he will perform well during interview and get a good salary job. Let us focus on an important aspect of knowledge transfer. You know, your institute is an engineering institute. So what you should do, knowledge transfer from academic research involving the indirect flow to entrepreneurship by individuals with a university education background. So you are teaching, you are involving your students, the whole team is doing something, teaching and research, and in the process you come up with some innovations, and then that innovation thing comes to your mind and you slowly you become an entrepreneur. And this is exactly happened with Google. You know, the owner of Google was not a great student of getting 99, but his mind was properly set to do something and become an entrepreneur. So the individuals become involved in new venture creation by means of corporate spin-offs, you know, the changing after gaining money byproduct after gaining industrial experience, rather than leaving university. What you can do? Oh, university job, only teaching. Forget this job, I'll go to an industry. That's not a good idea. You be in an university, be in your college, do a good teaching, motivate students, and send the student to some industry for training. You interact with the industry so that you learn something, and in the process you get back to your institute, your mother institute, and you incorporate the components which you have learned being in that industry for some time, students as well as faculty. The commercial knowledge gained by industry experience is potentially more valuable for entrepreneurial performance compared to the academic knowledge gained by additional research experience at the university. So you do, the recipe should be, my suggestion should be, a teaching, involved teaching, research component is there in teaching, and then send the students in the university, in the industry, you yourself interact with the industry, successful people, and then get your own student back and discuss your institute. That institute asks you to go there, you have learned something, how can we increase the standard of this institute in teaching and incorporating the concept of component of research. As for example, global competition, everywhere is global, you know, everything you do, iPhone I am using, so anything you use is all American product, but you can get it in no time. The global competition as well as ambition to go global, we did not have it. It's lacking. But nowadays, if you don't do it, you are nowhere. However, that is changing. I believe universities and institutes such as College of Engineering and Management Kolhapur are well placed to make a difference. So you must compete. First, competition starts within your institute, then other institutes within West Bengal, then institutes across the country, and then if you make a name for your institute, interact with good people in other institutes in different countries. Exposure to global competition is undoubtedly the best way to achieve global excellence. Because if you don't interact, and don't think I'm doing any propaganda, I was counting, I have traveled around 26 countries. And by doing that, in all scientific programs, I have learned so many things. In every country I have gone, whether France or Germany, America or Italy or Spain, I have gone, I spent some days and I realized, my goodness, that is nice way of teaching. Our teachers did not do, I also did not do. So now I go back and incorporate that in my teaching. So it helps a lot. Now you see, inventions and discoveries have emanated from creative mind. You have to be creative in mind. That I have been constantly working and imagining the outcome in the mind. If you are strong with imagination and constant effort, all the forces of the universe work for that inspired mind, thereby leading to innovations and discovery. You should not be, oh, it is not possible to do in Kolaghat. Oh, if I say it cannot be done in Kanpur, only Americans can do it, we cannot. Nothing will happen. You have to be bold enough. Because whether it is an American or a Britisher or German, doesn't matter. He is intelligent, I am also intelligent. I have less facilities, he has more. But does not mean that I am a fool. I can compete with him anytime. That should be your own knowledge base, so that you feel comfortable with to interact with anyone. Collaborative, if necessary, collaborative innovations. Technological innovations often involve collaboration among firms from diverse industries. There are many industries in Bengal or in India, interact with them. If you need some help, I can help you in my own way. Innovation and management scholars have increasingly emphasized the importance of collaborative innovation among firms from different domains. In particular, prior research has highlighted that heterogeneity of participants, various disciplines. I will be doing only with chemistry, no, some physics, some mathematicians. I regularly do magnetic studies with a person in Spain who is a physicist. He's a very, very well-known condensed matter physicist. But I have around 30-40 papers jointly with him and I. Basically, I create the molecules and I do not have that facility at IIT Kanpur. I send the compound to him and I get the measurements and I know what is going on. And both of us, we exchange our thoughts and views and we write papers. That is possible. The current theme in this line of research is that collaborative innovations among participants with heterogeneous knowledge sources could help generate non-redundant information flows, stimulate meaningful data debates, and pull together complementary resources and capabilities, thus leading to better innovation performance. So more and more you interact. In teaching, you interact with good people. In research, you interact with people in and around, within your institute, other people in Bengal, other in this country, and if possible, with the foreign countries. More and more you exchange your thoughts and views, your knowledge base got to grow. Mentoring graduate students in research and teaching by utilizing research as a template. This is you should do. Your institute should do. The primary goal of graduate education means, you know, in our country, America, graduate means PhD. So in our country, graduate education, that means BSc, MSc type or BTech. In science is to prepare students to as researchers for careers in either academic or industrial environments. And you have to do all this business, all the time, environment of learning. My son works in Dell Technology in Bangalore. And he is there for about a year. And he tells me, all the time, it is basically training. Because there's an American company. So his job starts at 6:30 or 7 Indian time and goes all the way to late night, maybe 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. Because with America, you have to do. But the point is, continuously they are teaching them how to do better. So when you are getting salary, you are an employee. Still they teach you so that you think and you evolve and you make even better contribute for the growth of Dell Technology, for my son is, and he will be going to some other company. Students are searching for careers in either academic or industrial environment. We should introduce a new graduate level course to examine the and augment, increase this research training via a guided inquiry, think about it, inspiring, who can inquiry? Students. Inspiring teachers. So teacher, student, and you guide them and then go to achieve a goal, then only it is possible to do well. Otherwise, it will never work. Course objectives for students. The course should be designed to address 6 major objectives associated with the success of researchers at the graduate level, like introducing the students to research group dynamics. In a class, you have 30 students. In a practical class, you make 4 or 4, some you know, 5, 5, 5. So 6 groups. So the each student, group of 6, they learn how to work together. So research group concept can be cultivated, inculcated in their mind and research group format. Exposing the students to new science and technologies through guided reading assignments. You give them something, study this. After studying, 6 of you, you present what you have understood. And if your understanding is not up to that mark, I will help you. So we say term paper in IIT. So in we give the student, take this topic, and 6 of you prepare a document, some 20 pages, 30 pages. And all 6 of you make a presentation, 2 minutes each. So 6 of them will take only 12 minutes. But in the process, what happened? The thinking process, learning process, presentation skill, speaking in English, everything gets geared up. Using inquiry to establish standardized best practice laboratory standard operating procedures in small groups. So the, all the techniques you are doing routinely in your laboratory bring a concept of some sort of research. You are doing some estimation of say something. Then you say, if we estimate how much this salt is there in IIT Kanpur, what we do that is your, we take peas. You know, peas in Bengali, motor shooting. So take peas and we extract DNA. And the students learn how to extract DNA from peas and how to characterize the DNA. So they get a feeling, the molecular weight of DNA, the properties of DNA, how do they look like under the microscope. The whole training comes. Doing the same experiment, it is written in the textbooks, American journals, Journal of Chemical Education. And the students are judged by seeing the DNA by his own, the genetic code of our survival. Exposing students to experimenting in cutting edge shared use facilities. You have one facility, so 6 of them will be using collecting data. Then these 6 goes, another 6 will be collecting data. In the process, lot of teaching based thing can be done as a component of research. In our country, I'm a member of that committee called Journal, named Resonance, published by the Bangalore Academy, Indian Academy of Sciences, Bangalore. The Resonance is a journal. If you have developed certain things in good teaching, you can publish there. Your article will be published. So there is a possibility to inspire students. Using peer review in grading of presentations. When the students are presenting, you learn how to grade, they will feel happy. Formulation of manuscript. So finally, you write something, submit a paper. Writing a manuscript covering the research carried out in the class. The students are charged to get a publication. And you are happy that even in my institute, which is may not have lot of facilities, but still in my university, the students are doing research. Then I'll scan through quickly. Team-based learning, faculty research, and grant writing. So all the points are there to identify deficiency in the knowledge. I can skip it so that it will become easy for you like this. Team-based learning. And that team does some experiment. So I have taken a biochemistry experiment. Could be a physics experiment. Could be a chemistry experience. And then you do some from these results to think about some research project, that this project can be formulated out of these experiments. And who has learned? The teacher and the students. And a research component has evolved out of those experimentation. Out of that experimentation, some research projects have appeared. And submit that project proposal for a grant, as a grant proposal to attract money. And when you get money, with that money, you can do something. There are many funding agencies to give money. DST, Department of Science and Technology, Science and Engineering Research Board, they give money called FIST program, F-I-S-T, that money for doing good teaching through instruments. So you have to explore that. Then, gap in knowledge. You have reading some subject.
And after reading some 20 papers, you realize that nobody is thinking about this aspect, or nobody has written about that gap. So gap in knowledge in chosen topic, that becomes your research question or central hypothesis, and specific aims and objectives, you know that from that questioning I can write what a project proposal, then how to design experiments, what will be the outcome, and then the whole cycle will be outline of the grant process, and finally once you have it, and then you are writing a grant proposal. So these three components is allowing you to write the grant proposals like this kind of thorough scheme. Students are involved, teachers are involved, and by studying first you have to study without doing any research, practical with instruments, that the gap, knowledge gap, and the gap in knowledge you identify, and then you think if this gap is there, how do we fill up that gap by appropriate experiments, and that experiment if you do, we can get this information, and then you know how to do it, and in the process you have specific objectives and aims, and you can submit a grant proposal to get some money for doing your research using this is called integrated course design approach that incorporates team based learning, faculty research, and mini grant proposal to support significant learning in the course is expected to help the faculty to continuously modify their teaching activities to be better aligned with assessment of student learning and enhance the metacognitive, means a critical awareness of thinking process, and once they become a thinker, skills of both faculty and student, and these kind of thing will lead to research publication, and the component of research is incorporated in your syllabus or your curricula. With this integrated course design, a significant learning template could be initiated for the course that can be updated with time to better serve, guide, and prepare students to become the competent scientific leaders of tomorrow. You have to have a dream, and you have to motivate them and inspire them and rekindle them, so that they become interested in doing so. And my point is, what kind of research will be doing if you have the facilities? We do research curiosity driven. If this happens, what about that? That is called fundamental in nature. Some will be industry driven. That means the research which has application potential. You should pay attention here, because you might be having industry interaction you should do, because it's an engineering phase. And relevance of society addressing national and global issues, like your COVID. The COVID research, if you can come up with some vaccine, you make billions of dollars. So research can be divided in these three domains: fundamental research, application, and society driven. Start doing your research activity keeping in mind the facility around you. There's absolutely no point in doing research on a topic where you lack necessary expertise and or facility or equipment. If you try to do, you cannot do much. So you have to look for your facility. Never start your independent research with your PhD postdoc topic. Then you won't go anywhere. You should look for a research area which will be your research, with experiences you had during your PhD postdoc, but not the research idea. Those research experiences you utilize, not the idea. One must set down research signature, own research signature. You wait for the time when your research attracts appreciation nationally. How? Submitting grant proposals, attending, delivering lectures, kind of thing. Internationally, the same story. Then you increase your research desire to do the more challenging areas research, because in the process you have money, you have bought some equipment. This process continues. The journey should never stop. You keep on upgrading. Believe me, you may not believe, when we became faculty member, I joined IIT Kanpur in 1987. Not much facilities were there at IIT Kanpur chemistry. Couple of faculty members who joined at the same time, same age group, we bought in IIT Kanpur. We attracted money. IIT Kanpur did not give anything. We attracted at least 10 crore of rupees from various funding agencies in India and made our department the top one. Institute said, we will give you infrastructural facilities, means room, electricity, air conditioning, that thing we'll do, but money we cannot. If you are smart, submit your project proposal, get money, we'll allow you to show your potential. Try to do good teaching and quality research. If you have a platform to perform, help to support you, and the desire to push you, the journey is endless. You never stop. I told you, I'm now 68. I'll be leaving Kanpur IIT on 30th June and 1st of July. For 2 years, I'll be joining IIT ISN Bangalore. So I'll be teaching there. I'll be doing research there. So always do something. That is very important. Then I'm coming to the end. Do not depend too much on your college or university for research support. To begin with, submit a humble research project. Do something, publish papers, ask for another project, more money, and in the process, you become independent and emotionally satisfied that I have my own money, I don't depend on. I'm a retired man. I have a project of around 25 lakh at IIT Kanpur. I don't take money from IIT Kanpur. With my own money, I survive. And then how to improve the quality of academic institution. Take a note of your institute. Meaningful academic curricula. Focus on e-learning electronically and digital library. The rounded education will empower students to realize their full potential and achieve goals. Knowledge has a higher purpose than simply making a living. You do something, you make money. But knowledge base is something you can, money will come to you. You don't have to run after money. Involve experts and alumni for evaluation and upgradation. In your institute, you should suggest to your director and the authorities that get involved, the experts and alumni. Periodic student placement, where the students are going after passing out. If they do good, your name of your institute will go high. If they do not do better, if they don't do much, then your name will never go. Periodic evaluation of students and faculty. The student is good or bad, the faculty judging. Faculty is good or bad, a student is judging, continuously should go on, semester after semester. Creating an ambience, quality student, faculty, state-of-the-art infrastructure may not be possible at your place. Interactive governance, possible. If the director is very friendly, and the deans, and the head, and the faculty members, and the students, you can form a one family. Meaningful research, fundamental, I said already, industry-driven and relevance to society. Then I said student and faculty mobility. You do not have much facility. A good student is there in Kolaghat, comes to IIT Bombay for a training for 2 months. So that means mobility of student. Do the same thing for the faculty mobility. Exchange of students and faculty with well-known national institutes and with renowned institutions abroad. Many institutions will give you an opportunity. Collaborations with experts, national and international, on quality research and on equal footing. Not being a chamcha of that American professor or some professor. You should have equal footing. You are knowledgeable, he is knowledgeable. Then only you can have your say. Otherwise, they will treat you as a student. Your prestige will go down the drain. We need generous funding, but we have to also remember academic auditing is important. I get money, and if I don't deliver, then every right is there for the institute director to question me. What have you done with that much money? Where is your auditing? How many papers you have published? How many students have been trained? That is called academic auditing. Outreach activities, helping the nearby. Academy industry interactions. Get connected with the society. Spread knowledge and extend the facilities created. You have some facility, ask other people, you can come nearby college. You can come and use it under your supervision so that the machine does not go bad. And in an academic environment, research shows that students who feel they belong have a higher degree of intrinsic motivation and academic confidence. So students should be a part of you. Students are not separate entity. Students and faculty should be one unit. According to students, their sense of belonging is fostered, generated by an instructor. who demonstrates warmth, very friendly, and openness, encourages student participation, enthusiastic, friendly, and helpful, and is organized and prepared for class. If you go to the class without preparation, the student realizes, yes, teacher aaj manage kar raha hai, he doesn't know much today, aaj padhai nahi kiya. Because you have to have your self-respect kept intact so that you make a name. The students must optimize that. Then the student's job is, the time they are spending, they should get a rounded education, because sharpen vocational skills so that when they leave the institute, they can face the world with confidence. It is my belief that students who looked at education in a dedicated and disciplined manner would surely achieve the knowledge and wisdom they seek for life's oncoming opportunity. Otherwise, it will not work. The students, they know it. Teachers have a lot to do with their students' motivational level. A student may arrive in a class with a certain degree of motivation. Teacher's behavior and teaching style, the structure of the course, the nature of the assignments, and informal interactions with students all have a large impact on students' motivation. Students get motivated when they identify a teacher dedicated. Always it is true. Our dream should be to train quality students for tomorrow's leaders, including faculty. I am very fortunate to say that. I have my PhD students in IITs, ICERs, NITs, Central Universities, colleges, and in industries like Unilever. So I try to inculcate in them, go ahead, face the world. The education system, that is school, college, university, research institute, must be periodically evaluated. We might say we are great. It has no meaning what others are saying. And curricula updated in accordance with the advancements. You have to keep on changing. In IIT, we have UGRC, Undergraduate Review Committee. We keep on changing the syllabus. And we take input from the students. Efforts should be made to make the education relevant to the students and economic demands without compromising on the ethical and moral values of education. Inculcating the spirit of discipline is very important. We, the faculty, must act in such a manner that we become the role model. The students get motivated to emulate, match, or surpass the teacher as a reason or achievement. So they should do better than us. While serving the institute, we all must make efforts to bring pride to our traditions and value system and focus on the betterment of the institute. Mindset and relevance of our work. Issue of developing a progressive and positive mindset. Learn new things. No, I don't need that. I am enough. That is not a good thing. I believe that continuing relevance in conjunction with the reality of the ground in terms of needs, essential factors to consider to justify. What do we do? I am coming to an end, only a couple of. These I have already said, scientific temper, be open in mind, cultivate inquisitive mind, thinking, keenness to learn new things, and cross boundaries of knowledge. A physics would interact with a chemist would interact with an engineer, then only the development or device will come. And then generally speaking, money brings knowledge, which, because with money you have an institute and knowledge will come, which leads to development. However, if you are knowledgeable, you bring money through your innovative skill. Your innovation will bring money to your institute. So knowledge can get money. Not that for knowledge you have to give money. Yes, I did not say, but Ramesh Masalkar of NCL Pune and the DG CSIR, he said this. Scientific and technological innovations are the key drivers for growth and economic prosperity of a nation. 21st century, as basic and applied sciences converge, there is an immediate need to train competent researchers. Without that, nothing will work. Some thoughts for the task for cutting edge research. Good research, I have written all kinds of things. We in India need to seriously address several issues that hinder the creation of borderless minds and borderless thinking. Our systems promote inhibition and imitation. They say you imitate, but don't be independent, rather than innovation. You should be innovation, not imitation. We should be innovative. Challenging broad-based research project with unique facilities, of course. And last but one, let us set a dream with a hard work, honesty, and commitment to reach one day to our dreamland with academic excellence. My greetings to all of you, the faculty members and all members of the College of Engineering and Management, Kolhapur, in the mission of developing quality human resource for the nation. And finally, I thank you for your, you know, attention. Now I am through. If you have some questions, I'll be happy to answer.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Ajay, how do I get out of this screen? Entering was the problem. Now, how do I do?
You can minimize this one.
Ajay, minimize button should work. Okay. So I'll be happy if you have some few questions specifically on teaching, research, and whatever I have said, I'll be happy to answer if I can.
If anyone having any questions, you can ask directly, sir. We'll be happy to answer.
Say again.
Sir, I'm saying it to the participants. They would ask you.
Hello.
Yes, sir. It is audible.
Yes. Tell me if you have any questions.
Sir, I have one question.
Yes.
In this pandemic situations, all these classes are in online mode.
Right.
So we are in the backside. In the class, what happened? We can look at the face of the student. We can understand that whether they are something learn or not. But in this case, how we can understood that student are understand what I am teaching them?
That is, you are giving home assignments, you are checking, because I have done the last 1 year, one last batch I taught at IIT Kanpur was 74 students, and the previous semester I had around 60. The point is, you give home assignments, you take exam, and you know the performance, and many students who are good, they will write to you, interact with you, and what we have done at IIT Kanpur, say if you have to have 3 classes in a week, so 2 classes, 2.5 or 2.25, and then the last class, 2.25, so you have 3/4 left out. So 3/4 will be interactive session to interact with the student. So in the, I taught through Zoom, so I could see the faces. Then suddenly a student says, sir, I have a question. Can you please clear it? So I say, then another student. So keep on, the students keep on asking me and I keep on answering. And then I say, if it is too long, then I say that, you know my email address, you can write to me and I'll answer. So you can evolve your own strategy, how to get connected with the student so that they don't suffer really, whether you are teaching using Blackboard or even using this e-learning process. But you have to have your, when you, I have taught, you know, there is a chance of the students copying during exam, right? If they are at home, they can do anything. So now the question is, there is a big challenge when you are setting the question paper, you set in such a manner, give them all books, still they will be having hard time. Your question should be planned in such a way, you have taught everything, but not the exactly that very problem. So if a student has understood, would be able to answer, put some component of analytical, some derivation, something which you have not said explicitly in the class, and there lies your intelligence to checkmate the student who are trying to fool you, so you fool them with your intelligence.
I given some numerical problem. Students are so intelligent. They are giving, somebody giving the answer. Actually, they are giving wrong answer. And they make their own group and they circulate this answer to everybody. And when I given the problem, they are solved. All of them are solved the wrong way. This type of things they also utilize.
So what you can do before the exam, you take quiz. You know, in IIT, There is a surprise quiz, Q-U-I-Z quiz. So what you do, you go and teach for half an hour and still you have 20 minutes, okay, or 15 minutes. Set two questions and you say, I will take this kind of quiz, maybe five of them. And your performance will decide. And just, you have taught something, but in the last two, three classes, whatever you have taught, you give them questions. And immediately they will not be able to answer and form a group and getting time. And you say, I will take this kind of quiz and out of, I will take six quiz and I will take the answer, a marks of best four. Best four out of six. Then you will find the students are serious enough, not only to copy, but also to learn.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
You have to do some sort of, you know, homework, how to manage the situation of this pandemic. Anyone else?
Anyone having any questions? You can ask.
Vida, ma'am.
No, I don't have a question. Thank you, sir, for the feedback. I really learned lots of things, a kind of a good brushing up also, like, you know, someone who's very good in his own field, giving his inputs, your experience. I think it was very much needed, a wake-up call. It's not that we didn't know anything. We knew a lot of things, but we seem to have forgotten. Yes, and someone was saying that we are on the right track. This is the way to move forward.
Thanks a lot. Thank you. Thank you. Dr. Mitra.
Yes, yes.
So whatever you say, you have invited me. So whatever you say, then only I will take a leave, otherwise whatever you feel like, I'm ready to do.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
And you're giving too much time for us.
No problem, I'll enjoy doing this thing.
Yes, yes. You will be retiring just 9 days after. At that time, you are giving too much time for us.
This morning, I had to go to many offices of IIT Kanpur to take my clearance. Because I am here for last 34 years. So lot of clearance required from this computer center, telephone exchange. So I have finished quite a bit. And then I was all set that I will do it. But there was some problem with computer, but that's what to do.
Yes. Actually, those are technical problems beyond our control.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes it happens, sometimes you cannot.
Yes, sir.
That is fine. Otherwise, it was my pleasure to interact with people. And I hope whatever little bit knowledge I have, I wanted to, you know, put across for you so that you think over it. And you have to always look for a unique way, your unique way of teaching. I'm very confident in my saying, I'll be leaving IIT Kanpur, but whatever I have taught the courses, many students are writing to me. I can forward those mails. Many students are writing, they have become faculty members. The nicer I sir Trivandrum faculty, he writes to me, sir, I was your student, IIT Kanpur will be missing your 442 inorganic chemistry. So I feel happy that, well, I tried to teach in my own way, maybe they have got impressed. So this is what, and the just now one colleague said that many things you people also know, but it's a refreshing kind of, think over it again and incorporate certain components. And the research component will play a major role. Bring some component of research. If you cannot have a lot of machines, but if you have the computational facility, train the students with DFT calculations.
Yes, sir.
Density functional theory. That is possible.
Yes, sir.
And they will be learning a lot of new things.
Just a plain laptop is sufficient.
Right.
Or
that is
what? Numerical calculation.
Correct. That is the way one should proceed.
And the desire.
Desire. That nobody can buy because it is yourself to go for it. And I am a person, I am never happy I always see I should have done so much I could not do. Because there should be that kind of thirst that I have to do something. Tomorrow should be better than today.
Yes, sir.
With all my best wishes to all of you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Another question. Sir.
Bye.
Now, Ashish, sir, you conclude the session.
Okay. So, am I audible?
Yes. It is audible.
So, we are grateful to our college authority for sponsoring this event. Our deepest acknowledgement goes to the expert, Professor Rabindranath Mukhopadhyay, Professor, Department of Chemistry, Emeritus Fellow, IIT Kanpur. We are extremely happy that we have Professor Mukherjee as expert in this event. Professor Mukherjee will be retiring on 30th June, just few days after. So during this busy schedule, he is giving much time for us. So we always look forward to his guidance and encouragement in our activities. We also thank Professor Cornell Dr. Povas Bose, Director of our college, for his constant support and guidance in organizing this event. Our heartiest thanks also go to the faculties and staff members of the entire college for extending their support. I thank all the honorable participants for their kind participation in this event. I request participants to submit the feedback form whose link is given in the chat box. Certificate of participation will be given to those attended this event. Thank you all.
And participants are requested to unmute their video so that we can make some group photos. Participant.
Joint photo.
Sukanto, you are not visible. Sukanto. Dikem sir, or any other Nirakunar ma'am. Madam. Kalokda.
Somirer mukh dekha jacche na. Anirban mukh ta ektu samne ano.
Webcam kintu on hocche na. O acha, allow.
Madam. Pinaki Pal.
Webcam kintu on hocche na go.
Ha, ektu on korun video ta.
Acha. Yes, it's on.
Amit Jana, Animesh Karmakar, Arunabh De, Arunabh Bhattacharj, Abhishek Kaur, Bishwajit Majumdar.
প্রবলেম হচ্ছে আমি একটু মেশিনে অন করতে পারছি না
চন্দ্রশেখর দেবলীনা দেবোত্তম ডিকেএম স্যার দীপন দীপিকা আইজি জেম কল্যাণ আশিস
স্লাইডটা সরিয়ে দিন তাহলে দিস স্লাইডটা সরিয়ে দিন তাহলে ফুল
স্ক্রিন আসবে স্লাইডটা কোথা থেকে সরাবো
আমি
রয়েছি তো
ও আমি দেখতে পাচ্ছি না ঠিক আছে ফটো তোলার জন্য নাকি ফটো ভিডিওটা অন করবেন TKM sir.
Video on করে বসে আছি.
না full screen. Now, Ashish sir.
Bolo.
End the session.
Can
we end the session?
তোমার ফটো তোলা হয়ে গেলে সকলের ফটো তোলা হয়ে গেলে কেটে দাও
স্যার একটা কথা ছিল আগেবারে কি সার্টিফিকেট দেয়া হয়ে গেছে ফার্স্ট যেটা 31st মে 12 মে তে হয়েছিল
হ্যাঁ 12 মে দেয়া হয়েছে
আমি কিন্তু
পাইনি
না ফর্মও ভরেছিলাম
ঠিক আছে আপনি একটু
আমিও পাইনি
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা একটু ফোনে কথা শুনবো তাহলে
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে
ওকে
চ্যাট বক্সে দেখো পাবলিক চ্যাট অলোক মাইকে একটা লিংক দিয়েছে দেখো ওই যে সংবাদের বাঁদিকে দেখো সংবাদের বাঁদিকে পাবলিক চ্যাট মেসেজ দেখতে পেয়েছো আর তোমায় আমি ইমেইলে পাঠিয়ে দিচ্ছি
ওটা ওটা না মেইলে আসি সবাইকে পাঠিয়ে দাও
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে
ফটো তোলা কি হয়ে গেছে ফটো তোলা
নাও এভরিবডি লিভ নাও ওকে উই ক্যান এন্ড দ্য সেশন
নিয়া হয়ে গেছে
হ্যাঁ
দেখা যাচ্ছে আমাকে দেখা যাচ্ছে আপনার কিন্তু ক্যামেরাটা একবার হেজি
না তোমাকে আলাদা করে পাঠিয়ে দেবো
কিছুই আসছে না ভয়
না 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 তুমি তো আউটসাইড তোমার লাগবে না
শুভ্রা তোমার ক্যামেরাটা একবারে বয়ে যাচ্ছে
ইয়েস স্যার বোঝা যাচ্ছে না
পুরো ফ্রগ যেন কুয়াশা হয়ে গেছে
এবারে
দিদি এবার কতক্ষণ থাকবো